and good evening. I'm Marsha D'Souza and you're watching Goa 365. Our headlines at the hour. Congress party has finally felt the heat of SEZ movement. Request government to scrap SEZ in its present form. Demands give the government till 2nd January 2008 to decide on SEZs. People get set to usher in the new year. We also have Goa this week. Now the news in detail. Though the Congress has almost given in to the demands of the people of scrapping SEZs, they are not averse to the same allotted land to be converted into industrial estates. This was disclosed by GPCC President and Lok Sabha Member Francisco Sardina at a press briefing yesterday.
So if tomorrow government denotify the SEZ and convert that land into industrial estate, will Congress support for that?
Why not? Then for industrial estate, you may not need that much of land.
Briefing media persons after the PCC Executive Committee meeting yesterday, Mr. Sardina said that the Congress party had requested government to denotify all notified SEZ in state.
So in fact, they have requested the government to denotify whatever SEZs that have been notified, if it is.
In what seems to be inspiration from Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, suggestion that the state government should strive to make Goa number one tourist destination in world. Mr. Sardina suggested government not to go ahead with SEZ in its existing form.
That SEZs in the existing forms, we should not go ahead with the SEZ in the existing form.
He also suggested government not to acquire any more land for any other purpose other than for public utility.
The main stress was on SEZ policy, and our party is of the opinion that first of all, government should not acquire land for SEZs or any other purpose in future other than whatever public works that are needed in the interests of the people.
Changing his tunes, he also opposed SEZs in private land in state.
Software parks.
Yes. So it is like that. You see another country coming up, you want to bring to your country so that we also come up.
Ironically, Sardina during the Lok Sabha campaign has strongly advocated two SEZs for Goa. Goa movement against SEZ decided to stall their agitation till 2nd January 2008 upon the assurance of the Chief Minister Digambar Kamath to convey the government's decision on SEZ. However, Mr. Kamath told the media that he is not committed to the deadline.
Today is not my day to meet media. I will meet media openly. Nothing like that.
So just one line, sir. What will happen?
Let us see. I had called them to listen to their viewpoint. I have discussed their viewpoint. I said I am doing consultation process. After that, I will come back to media.
Sir, what is this to the 2nd January directive, sir?
Okay. Let us see.
Earlier, Mr. Kamath discussed the issue with Mithani Saldana and Leader of Opposition Manohar Parrikar and Lok Sabha Member Sripad Naik at his official residence at Altino. Speaking to Goa 365, Leader of Opposition Manohar Parrikar said that BJP is satisfied with the assurance given by Chief Minister.
By 2nd, he will come out with a clear direction to the full problem of SEZ. On that aspect, definitely BJP appears to be quite satisfied, because we are meeting as it is on 1st. We can wait for one more day. Ultimately, we also want the issue to be solved on table rather than on our agitation, because people can't be put to trouble. I think by now people know.
Jamas also decided to wait and watch till 2nd January 2008 before deciding future course of action.
We have decided that since the Chief Minister is going to come out with a clear-cut decision on 2nd, we will pause, we'll wait. Because I think the Chief Minister, for the first time, he has decided to say that okay, that he is going to do something which we accept that it will be satisfying to us, not as individuals, but as for Goa. in the interest of Goa. If that happens, we are happy. So there are hardly 2 days from now that will become second, and we will pause for a while or wait for a while. Until then, we will take a decision of future course of action only upon his decision on second.
Meanwhile, youth of Goa presented a memorandum to Chief Minister Digambar Kamath, signed by 8,443 youth, stating reasons for demanding the scrapping of SEZs in Goa. Youth of Goa convener Melissa Simoes told us that they are not satisfied with the approach of Chief Minister on SEZs.
You are not satisfied with the
Not at all with what the Chief Minister said.
We are still hopeful in that democracy, that we have given almost 8,500 signatures along with our memorandum. So let's hope for the better, and we'll continue with our awareness in the general public and hope for better results in the coming days.
We have Goa This Week coming up after the break.